Welcome back to My Face. My name is Brianna and I'm the head honcho here at Bamby Media. If you've clicked on this video, it means that you're probably a podcaster that's looking to improve the quality of your podcast production. In this series of videos, you're going to learn how to record and edit your podcast using Descript, and there will be a link to Descript in the description below. Yes, we're also an affiliate of theirs because they are pretty flippin' awesome. If you'd prefer to consume this content in order, then you need to head to bambymedia.com/DIY podcaster. You'll just need to create an account to actually get into the back end of that, but it is completely free at no cost to you, which rarely happens these days, so I'm pretty excited about doing that. If you'd like to work with us here at Bamby Media, you can also just head to bambymedia.com and there is a bunch of ways to work with us. All right, let's dive in. Thanks for joining me back again. Now we're going to go through and actually edit this episode. So we've got here the timeline with the waveform. We can expand that and you understand now there's layers. So there's this top layer with nothing in it at the moment. And then there's the actual waveform, the recording that you did. And then down here, up here, we've got the transcript of exactly what was said. So you can actually just use the transcript to edit and then use this as your guide below. You can see here at the very beginning, I said something and then I kind of repeated myself. Welcome to the very first episode. And I didn't want to include that. I wanted to start it again. So I'm going to just highlight, just like you would a Google Doc, and I'm going to delete so that it starts where I want it to actually start. The next thing I want to do is I want to go over to my audio effects. I want to hit the plus button and do exactly what we did with the intro and get your EQ set from the beginning. Welcome to the very first episode. I'm so glad to have you here. And today we're going to be discussing what makes a really good podcast editor. The thing that I think when I think about editing is you really want to make sure that you're highlighting the... You've got to make sure that your EQing is correct, that your compression is correct, and that you've spent the time going through the audio with a fine-tooth comb to make sure that you get rid of anything that should. Okay, so I've done the EQ. This will take you a long time in the beginning to get sort of right, and you'll get used to how your microphone sounds as well. With this particular microphone, it needs a bit of help in the bottom end. And there's some treble frequencies here that I feel like they just grate on me. When you turn them right up, it's like, meh, you know, it really hurts my ears. So I just pull them all the way out and then I'm set. Now I'm going to go over to my compression. Compression doesn't really change. Once you've set it and you know the space that you're in, it's minus 13 there and you're good to go. Okay, now we're going to set those things up. We're going to hit record and we're going to start editing some more. Welcome to the very first episode. I'm so glad to have you here. And today there's a little sound here that I don't like. And I can actually just cut that out by S, press S and press S again. And it gives me this little area. I'm just going to take that little saliva sound out. Episode. I'm so glad to have you here. There's a bit more. So I might just bring that up. Episode. There it is. It's actually here. Episode. I'm so glad to have you here. And today we're going to be discussing what makes a really good podcast editor. The thing that I think when I think about editing is you really want... And so see how that was kind of laboring. And I said the thing that I think when I think about, you know, not great. So you can go up here and go, all right, the thing that I think when I think blah, blah. And I'm going to go get rid of all of this, delete, and just go from there. And then I'm going to just scroll back a bit. You really want to... And there's a little saliva noise I'm just going to remove. You really want to make sure that you're highlighting the best audio for that podcast episode. You've got to make sure that your EQing is correct, that your compression is correct, and that you've spent the time going through the audio with a fine-tooth comb to make sure that you get rid of anything that shouldn't really be there, like ums and ahs and awkwardness, any dogs barking. All this sort of stuff should really be thought about when you're going into a new podcast editing project. The next thing to really think about is the story development. So when you're editing the episode, is it boring? Okay, so then I'm going to get rid of the "so when you're editing" because I don't think you need it. development. Is it boring? That's one of the main things. Is it a boring episode? Is there things that you can do to tighten it up other than you getting rid of the awkward? And that's a bit of an awkward thing here.
And what you can do there is if you feel like it just seems a little bit weird, you can crossfade it like this. So you just drag this across and you can crossfade it and it actually makes it sound a little bit better.
Other than getting rid of the awkwardness and the ums and the ahs and those sorts of things, where does it really start to lose its way? And where can you tighten things up or create more depth? Do you need to re-record some things? Do you need to ask the client to re-record some things? How is it going to be portrayed? And how?
So we're going to get rid of that.
Some things. And how is the listener going to experience that episode?
So you can see, big cough. I'm going to just press S and press S again. Highlight that bit, press delete.
So that's my thoughts on that for today, and I hope it was really valuable for you. Thanks for joining me. And if you want to touch base with me at all, please just head over to our website, bambymedia.com, or you can contact me on Instagram in the DMs as well. Have a great day.
Let's pretend that that's the episode. The next thing that you can do is if you're really struggling with the sound, like you're sounding too far away from your microphone and you're not really sure how to fix it, like you can hear with mine, my audio is really close, isn't it? It sounds really beautiful. You can hear me really well. And I haven't had to use this thing called studio sound. But in this next lesson, what I will teach you is what to do if you have audio that is troublesome and you feel like you might need to apply studio sound. So if that's something that you need, then definitely go into this next lesson and watch the studio sound module.